You ever check into a hotel and they got that motherfucker to come out the ceiling straight down? That's some racist shit. Yeah, they ain't thinking about niggas. No, they not. They thinking about white folks. This shit here coming straight from the ceiling. We ain't niggas no more that. What, to hit our hair first, then the rest of our body? No. White folks like that. That make them feel like they in a rainforest or waterfall. No, niggas want that spout out the wall where the water descend down and we can decide how much water we want on our head, if any. If any. You go straight out the ceiling shit. Now you got motherfuckers washing up like this in that motherfucker.
A lot of things have changed, but not the audacity of men. I did not miss talking, hearing, interacting with men at all. I'm not a man hater, let me just say that. I know that's the wave. I'm not a man hater, but I always give them the benefit of the doubt, you know? I have to believe that they don't know how fucking weird and creepy they been all the goddamn time, you know what I mean? I have to believe that. Or I won't go outside. You know what I mean? I feel like that's how most women operate. You know what I mean? We like, I know there's some good ones out there, right? That's what we. That's how we think. So we can go about our life. You know? I heard my sister married one. Her brother, he was a good man. That's how we do it. You know what I mean? I heard one time. Now he dead, but I know. I'm a comedian. I ride in Ubers. I come home late, 3 a.m. sometimes. How dare me? I know. But these drivers, they pull up to the house. It's 3 a.m. They say shit like, you live here alone? Like, why would you say that? Why don't you know that's creepy? That's happened to me multiple times. You live here alone. Like, 20 minutes of silence. This is what you choose to say. And when you choose to say it, what is happening right now? They turn you into a liar. You gotta be like, no, it's just me and my two husbands. And our pit bulls, you know. We run a pit bull academy if you wanna come by. It sucks, because I love Ubers. That's how I pretend that I'm rich. I get in, I'm like, drive. That's my shit. And they fuck it up for me. I want to take naps and shit in the Uber, but you can't nap in the Ubers, right? Not with a male driver, ladies, we know that. Can't sleep. Can't even catch a wink. Every once in a while, I get a female driver, that little thing pops up. I see the woman face. I'm like, ah, just light a joint. I'm about to relax. You know what I mean? I love it. Hey. Not with the male driver. Can't do that. You gotta, you know? Gotta let them see the whites, you know? You gotta not only be awake, you gotta make sure they know you're awake. So that's posture and, you know? I like to roll the window up and down. Am I cold? Am I hot? What I am is awake. Gotta fart, everyone. Oh, that was me. That was me. I would not touch me if I were you, sir. Oh, that's a wet one. That was, ooh. I am so unrapeable. I can't even. Gotta stay alive. I've only fallen asleep one time with a male driver. I remember it like it only happened once. That's why I remember it so clearly. I was sleeping. And you ever hear the law and order, chung chung, like in your head. I thought it was on the radio, it was so clear, like chung chung, and it was just my brain, my alert, like, what the fuck you doing? And you know? And sure enough, that weirdo was staring at me dead in my eyeballs, and he didn't look away. That's a murderer. Right? That's a murderer. Same people know, you get caught staring, hey, sorry, you know what I mean? They're embarrassed. No, he was, you know what I mean? And, you know, I live in New York, so I'm like, you know what I mean? But he didn't look away. That was 10 minutes of extended eye contact on that ride. I'm farting for my life in the back. It was crazy.
Tiger Woods. boys went downhill when he started cheating on his wife. Only little boys do that. You got a good rider, a good woman with you by your side, you don't cheat on her. You got a good woman by your side. And what I'm saying in essence, fellas, don't go chasing waterfalls. Please stick to the rivers and the lakes you used to. Chasing them young girls out there, one of them young girls gonna give you herpes in your mouth. And everybody in CVS know what that cream is for. You don't want to be that dude in your 50s sitting in that free clinic with them young motherfuckers. Just sitting there.
Excuse me, are you the doctor?
No, I got clap. I'm next.
What is clap?
Old school VD.
After we get our shots, could you buy me and my friends a case of beer?
You gonna give me some young bitches?
That's arrested development. You gotta grow the fuck up. You do. Can't keep doing the shit you was doing when you was 18. I was watching Couples Therapy the other day. They have Flavor Flav on there. Flavor Flav is 62 years old. I'm not calling no 62-year-old man Flavor Flav. What is your real name, Derek? And take that clock off, goddammit. Arrested Development. He had a hat on to the side with reading glasses on. When you have reading glasses on, it's time to turn the brim around to the front and become a real Padres fan. And put a belt on, goddammit. Them young shags out there. That's why I don't go to strip clubs no more. That's Arrested Development. I don't go to strip clubs no more. I just got tired of fighting with them bitches on how many songs I paid for in the lap dance. I said 3 songs. Mixtapes don't count. I just got tired of them bitches recognizing me in the street while I'm with my wife and kids. Hi, Tracy. It's me, Janet, AKA Cinnamon. Damn it, Cinnamon. I said, don't talk to me unless we're in the boom boom room. You don't want to be that old man bringing flowers on Valentine's Day at the strip club. You don't want to be that. Hi, Cinnamon, these are for you. Oh, these are so nice. Could you sit these in that water over there while I lap dance this guy till he comes in his pants? Arrested Development. Women, y'all got Arrested Development too. Me and my wife went to a wedding 2 weeks ago. And when you get to a certain age, this is dancing, two-stepping. That's all you got to do. It's one move. Stomach out, stomach in. 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 That's all you gotta do. We dancing next to this 50-year-old woman, and this bitch start doing all the Sierra shit. And I was still smiling, but in my mind I was saying, if this bitch kicked me in the femur, I'ma knock her the fuck out.
Pretty insane word, right? Schadenfreude. Why would you want that? To indulge in others' pain and suffering. Why would you? You know, but then when I thought about it, I was like, it sounds terrible, but we all do it. Yeah, every single one of us in this room, we all experience Schadenfreude. You know? We all do. We all, you know when you have Schadenfreude? It's when you're driving on the highway. Yeah? And you're cruising along, everything's going well, and you look over on the other side, and the traffic is packed up, and you get that little feeling inside, like, I made the right choices in life. That's Schadenfreude. You know what Schadenfreude is? Schadenfreude is what happened when black women saw middle-aged white men crying after Disney said they were changing the Little Mermaid. That's Schadenfreude. That was one of the funniest things I've ever seen in my life. Grown men crying.
This is ruining my childhood. They changed the Little Mermaid. She looks nothing like the original.
Nothing?
She looks nothing like the original, really, nothing. There is nothing that reminds you of the original Little Mermaid when you look at her. Nothing at all. You realize the only thing that changed is the color of her skin. This part of the color of her skin. The hair's red. The body is fish. That doesn't remind you of the Little Mermaid? That was the main thing that you recognized the Little Mermaid? Really? You know what schadenfreude is? Schadenfreude is what everybody from Ireland and Kenya and Trinidad and Jamaica and South Africa and India all felt when the news came out and said, the royal family has bad news. People don't understand. People were like, no, are you laughing at this? Are you laughing at this? It's like, yes, first of all, but you're misunderstanding it, right? The royal family always gets sensitive about people responding to their bad news, but they don't seem to understand that's not really bad news. Every time the royal family wants us to feel sorry for them, is it really bad news? Huh? They'd be like, please, we ask you for your sympathy right now. We have lost Harry and Meghan. You've lost them? Like they're missing? No. Your favorite British couple has now become your favorite American couple. The royal family has bad news. Is it bad news? Yes, it is. The Queen has died. Died of what? Finishing life. Are you kidding me? I'm not saying someone shouldn't grieve, but she finished life. Do you know how many human beings don't get to do that? She finished it. She died as queen. Died of what? Old age. That means you finished the game. Done. Credits are rolling. Buried with the jewels. Hashtag winning. You want the colonies to be sad? Those are their jewels. Africans were like, can we have our diamonds back? They're like, no. The queen takes them with her. You kidding me? People are like, well, I mean, this is not the time to be talking about her. You shouldn't be saying bad things about her. It's not, you shouldn't be speaking ill of the dead. No, that's exactly what you should do. Yeah, the perfect time to talk shit about people is when they're dead. All right? Can we agree on this in society? Maybe we should start being nicer to each other when we're alive and let's talk shit when people die. All right? Do that for me, people. Do that. When I'm dead, say whatever you want about me. When you see me in the streets, just say hi. You know why? Because I'm gone. People are like, these people up there and they're dancing on her grave. Yeah, that's what graves are made for. That's why they made them flat. The whole point was that people could come and dance on them. Otherwise, they would have made them slanted so you would slide off. And even in that, the queen is winning. She's got some of the best dancers dancing on her grave. Huh? Can you imagine the Africans coming in and they're just there, huh? Doing their thing. Then the Irish are like, we're up next. Hey, oh, save us some space on the grave. You've got the Indians coming in. Now it's our moment. Finally, everyone from the Caribbean, murder, she wrote.
It was the texting. Fuck! Oh! Who invented texting? Who invented texting? Wasn't a woman. No, let me tell you. Because texting shows exactly how crazy a bitch really is. Yeah, ladies, it's in writing now. You always wonder why your man calling you a crazy ass bitch? Go back and read some of your texts. You will see that you are a psycho. You know we don't appropriately use that shit. We'll pick the phone up in a minute and be like, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. You need to respect me. You need to R-E-spec me. Because I keep it 100. Then we do that emoji, that 100 emoji. 100, 100, 100, send. But we women, we're emotional. An hour later, we're like, I'm so sorry about that text. It was unnecessary and immature. But that's why I love you, bae. Because you know that I'm passionate. Are we still gonna hook up tonight? Because it ain't like it used to be in the good old days. You remember good old days, the answer machine? Oh man, that's when stalking used to be so pure. Like you can call and leave a fucked up message. Fuck you, fuck your mama, I'm gonna fuck your homeboy Tony and your dick small. Call back, figure out the code, erase the message. Do that shit 6-7 times, he don't even know you crazy. Not texting, that shit is instant. That shit go right to the motherfucker. You can't cancel it, you can't pull it back, you can't do shit. What we need is an app. We need an app. So when we talking shit like that, the app be like, uh-huh. Mm-hmm. All right. Mm-hmm. 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 Yeah. Mm-hmm. You sure you want to send that shit out? Okay. Mm-hmm. You are at 85% crazy right now. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We're going to send you a picture of your face of what it looked like right now. Or why you texting the one that you love. Your face not supposed to look like that. And you get a picture from the app and your face is like. But you still send it. Cause it's so easy, you guys. It's so easy to pick the phone up and be like, you's a bitch and so is your mom, send. I didn't have to call your mama, bitch. Gladys is one of the nicest people I have ever fucking met in my life. She's so nice. Every time I go over there, she's so fucking nice. Please tell Gladys that I love her. Sent. Are you getting any of your texts? Because I've been texting you all day, question marking you and shit. That's why I don't fuck with you, because you ain't shit. You ain't worth the salt in your motherfucking bread. I swear, fuck you and everything that you stand for. The fucking horse you rode in on. Fuck you, you piece of shit. Sin. There I go again. Always going the fuck off and don't know what the fuck I'm going off for. You might be busy, you might be at work, you might be asleep. Are you asleep? But that's why I love you, bae. Cause you know I'm passionate. Naked picture, naked picture, naked picture, naked picture, naked picture, naked picture, naked picture. Sin. I'm outside.
Who in here used to be racist? Niggas in here like, used to be. Still is, nigga. You know what some racist shit is in hotels? Overhead showers. You ever check into a hotel and they got that motherfucker to come out the ceiling straight down? That's some racist shit. Yeah, they ain't thinking about niggas. No, they not. They thinking about white folks. When I see shit like that, they let me know ain't no black people on the board over there. If it was, it'd be one nigga like, I don't know. This shit here coming straight from the ceiling, man, niggas don't want that. Water hit our hair first, then the rest of our, but no. White folks like that, that make them feel like they in a rainforest or waterfall. No, niggas want that spout out the wall where the water descend down and we can decide how much water we want on our head, if any. If any. A little straight out the ceiling shit. Now you got motherfuckers washing up like this in that motherfucker.
I grew up here in the city of Atlanta, and I tell you, when I was a little girl, we used to move a lot. Well, we got evicted a lot. My mama made sure that when we got evicted, she made sure we got evicted in the same neighborhood so we wouldn't have to switch schools. The bad part about being evicted was my mama would always make us go knock on our old door and ask dumb shit like, did we get in the mail today? Like, knock, knock. Mama said, we get in the mail. Knock, knock. Mama said, we get in the mail. She would like to know if she can borrow a pack of chicken and two tampons. And my mom was very particular about the houses she rented, y'all. She used to love to rent a house with a chimney. And I thought the reason why she wanted the house with the chimney is because she wanted Santa Claus to come see her black kids. But that's not what it was. The reason why she wanted a house with a chimney, because we were poor as fuck and we couldn't afford light and gas, so she would always keep the fucking lights on and we would have to cook in the fucking fireplace. Nigga, you would come over our house in the summertime, it's 100 degrees, we got a Cracker Barrel fireplace going. Looking with a whole rack in there frying chicken on pine wood. The walls sweating, we sweating, we in our underwear looking like we just got off a fucking boat. My mama got the only fucking fan in her face watching The Young and the Restless. Pine wood and grease back there popping on her. We back there, mommy, it's hot, it's hot. She was like, take it like a man. I'm like, bitch, I am a girl. Couple days later, I get to school, y'all, and my principal coming to me, a big old tall man with thick-ass glasses. Looked like if he couldn't read, he could have made it to the NBA. He come up to me, and he was like, young lady, I need to speak to you in the office. So I walk in the office, and no lie, the police there, the counselor there, my teacher there, and he's there. And all these motherfuckers standing there looking at me, I'm like, what the fuck going on? Because you know I've been cussing my whole damn life. And he looked at me, he said, we noticed that you got a bunch of bruises and blisters and burns all on you. We want to know what's going on at the house. Are you a cutter? I'm like, nigga, no. I was frying chicken in the chimney. He looked at me and said, get your black ass back to class. Thought you was being abused. I'm like, bitch, I am being abused. Shouldn't be frying no fucking chicken in no chimney in no fourth grade. Couple days later, I'm sitting in the cafeteria, my friend complaining about her mama. She's like, my mom ain't shit. I'm like, shit, my mom ain't shit either. My friend said, but I hear it's a better place we can go to. I'm like, a better place? The fuck this better place at? She was like, it's called juvenile. We just gotta get there. I'm like, well, how do we get there? She said, what you gotta do is you gotta run away, go to convenience store and steal something, and then they gonna send this white car with these red lights on top to give you a ride. The police. Y'all, I get locked up for running away and stealing at the convenience store, and no lie, I spent 5 days in juvenile. But during that time, I learned a lot. My first day there, y'all, they ring this bell like ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling. It's chow time. And no lie, y'all, the lady walked me in this room and all of these plates was already prepared with food and shit. And I'm walking with her and I started looking at the plates and I noticed stuff I had never seen before. And I'm like, ma'am, what type of meat is that? She was like, chicken. And I'm like, what type of chicken is that? She was like, legs and thighs. And I had never had a leg and thigh, so I asked him, like, y'all ain't got no ass and backs. Well, baby, that's all my mama ever cooked with ass and backs. My mama didn't take us no McDonald's. She made us a 6-pack McAss. And think about it, some of y'all eat y'all ass on fried.
Listen, my mama's strict. Anybody got a strict mama? My mama told you something, she meant it. One time my mama told me, you know, I got lost in the mall. My mama didn't even look for me. She didn't even look for me. I had to find a security guard to help me look for my mama. I said, come on, man, hurry up before she leave. Mama! Mama, where you at? Mama! I'm sorry! Man, I went everywhere in that mall looking for my mama. My mama wasn't even in the mall no more. Found my mama in the parking lot back and back. I said, oh, there she go. Mama! I'm sorry, Mama. I said, I thought you had a ride home. The car is too full. Mama, I'm only 5 years old, but you think you grown. I told you not to leave my side. I thought she was gonna come back. She left me out there all night long. I couldn't. Wouldn't nobody even kidnap me. Kidnappers don't kidnap black kids. We're too much trouble. We ask too many questions. We be in the back seat asking questions. We don't be quiet. We be scared, but we wanna know what's going on. Miss Kidnapper? Mr. Kidnapper? Where we going? Mr. Kidnapper? Where we gonna eat? Mr. Kidnapper. Mr. Kidnapper. Can you put the radio on the black radio station? Maybe a little baby face, earth, wind, and fire or something. Get a little scared, man. Kidnap this kid. Get the hell out, boy. Get the hell out of the car. Drive me even more crazy. God damn. Do you realize your life is in danger, boy? Get out. You kidnapped me, man. Get more money to keep me alive, shit. Yeah, my mama, man, she didn't play, man. My mama made us go to church. Made us. We didn't even sin yet. We still had to go to church. Like, get up, you are going to church. Mama, can't the preacher come here sometimes? We always going to him. He can preach on the kitchen table, Mama. Get up, you are going to church. Make me sick. Make me late. She always talking about we making her late. And she ain't dressed neither. Walking around with her bra on. You are making can't get dressed fooling around with y'all. You can't get dressed because you ain't dressed, Mama.
We'd fight all the time. We fight over stupid shit. Just because I didn't know. Stuff I didn't know. I always hated that she assumed that I would know things that I couldn't possibly know. Like, I didn't know periods weren't fun. It looks fun in the commercial. I have sisters. They get their periods. But you know, they didn't even call it a period. They'd be like, it's my time of the month. And I'd be like, okay, have a good time. Can't wait till I grow up and get some time for myself. And that's all they'd say about it. They never even fucking talked about it. They didn't talk about it the way I would talk about it if I got a period. If I got a period, it'd be all I talked about. It'd be my excuse for everything. Like, Shay, you're 3 hours late for work. Nigga, I got my period. We understand that, but that's the third time this month you've used that excuse. Well, I play sports in high school. My shit's irregular. What the fuck you want from me, man? I'm all bloated and shit. My girl get her period, man, and she wouldn't even say nothing about it. She would just be suffering. I would feel so bad. I know she didn't want to talk to me about it because she thought she maybe couldn't talk to me about it. So I would try to say something to let her know that she could talk to me about it if she wanted to talk to me about it. Like, I'd ask her. I'd say, hey, what are you, on your period or something? Yeah, that's not how you do that. She would get so mad. Why the fuck would you ask me that? Like, I don't know, because you're miserable and I would be too if I was stuffed with cotton. She would make it seem like it was a dumb guess. Like, it was a fucking good guess. She got a period for a week every month. It's like a 1 in 4 chance I'm right anytime I ask that question. It's not a stupid question. If you knew that I smoked crack for 1 week every month, and then one day you see me outside butt naked in Timberlands trying to sell a refrigerator door, you're like, Che, you smoking crack this week? Why would you ask me that? It's dismissive. She called me toxic. That's a rotten thing to call somebody, right? Especially if it's true.
Ooh, can I tell you, I just wrapped a movie with J-Lo. What? J-Lo, excuse me, she is beautiful. Are you kidding me? She is, I couldn't stop staring at her. I was like, oh, my line. She's like an athlete that can dance, that's a businesswoman in a tank top. I say, yes, you go with your good knees and edges, J-Lo. The hardest part of working with J-Lo is pretending that I didn't know everything about her. I know everything about J-Lo. For example, I know that we have the same birthday. Yes, July 24th. But I didn't want to tell her the first day because you can't. I don't want to be the creepy girl on the set. You know what I mean? But there's always somebody at the office that's into astrology. You know who you are. Always worried about the sun and the moon. Never get taxes. So we had one of those assholes on set. I said, okay, I'm going to wait for my moment. And sure enough, 3 weeks later, he goes, oh, you and Jen have the same face because you're both Leos. I said, oh, this is my moment. So I said, Jen, you a Leo? She said, yes. I said, Jen, I'm a Leo. She said, stop. I said, I will not. I said, Jen, when's your birthday? Yo, I was so good at this. Meryl Streep would be like, give that bitch the Oscar. Okay, just give that bitch the Oscar. So I said, Jen, my birthday is July 24th. What? She said, no. I said, yes. She said, your birthday is July 24th. I said, isn't that crazy? She said, no one has my birthday. I said, I know, it's so special. I said, Jen, we should have a joint birthday party. And then she walked away. didn't talk to me for like 3 hours. That's okay, she came back. You know, I got big tits, freckles, big hair. It's friendly, people are like, let's talk to it. True. So she came back and she wanted to like spill the tea, you know? And she was like, oh man, have you ever dated Leo? I said, where we going with it, Jen? I said, where are we going? She's like, no, have you ever dated Leo? Because they're like, you know, so difficult. I said, oh, honey, I done fucked the whole Zodiac calendar. No one plays the lotto once, you know what I mean? You don't learn how to ride a bike the first time. I said, yeah, all that. And she's like, oh, I was engaged to Leo. And I was like, really? That's so crazy. Yeah, she's like, it wasn't the easiest with Ben. I said, Ben who? Benjamin Button? Benjamin Franklin? Who are Ben? And she's like, I'm so happy now, though, because I'm engaged to Leo, but he's great. He's an athlete. He's Dominican. I said, oh, that sounds spicy.
I've been doing this ongoing prank to my mom, this text message prank to my mom. I call it autofill roulette. You know, like, you know when you're sending a text and the little three little words come up? If you just press those words willy-nilly, it makes this like crazy run-on Mad Lib sentence. And if you text that shit to your mom, it drives her fucking nuts. So I was wondering, it's not too late. Is there anybody's mom who's awake right now? We can get a few moms going that we can do this text message prank to. Is that cool with you guys? Okay, hand your phone to Joe. How are we gonna do this? Come on up, we'll figure it out. Yes, okay, yes, perfect, yes. Okay, great, all right. I won't say anything that the phone doesn't say, okay? I'm only gonna say shit. Perfect. How long do you have? It's the phone, it's not me. 0 stars for a good night. Not good. Probably my mom and her sister and her daughter in the shower. Not me. Take it up with Apple. Take it up with Apple. Thank y'all for being such a bitch. It's your phone. You shouldn't write bitch in your phone so much if you didn't want this to happen. What do you think? Do you think your mom's like, what the fuck is going on? Or you think she's just watching Dateline? Oh, oh, here we go. Are you okay? No. No, ma'am. Oh, oh shit. Can I answer it? What's up, mom? Say hi to New Orleans.
Oh, no. This is crazy. You woke me up.
You're on my Netflix special.
Oh, you're kidding me.
Yeah. Nice to meet you. I'm Key and Peele.
Oh my God. How did you get my number?
I stole your son's phone when they arrested him.
Oh my gosh.
Just send me 20,000 in Bitcoin if you want to see him alive.
My woman is younger than me because I'm in show business. And I love listening to her music. And sometimes I realize my oldies are gonna be better than hers. You know? I love the period I grew up in. I grew up listening to the Beatles and Earth, Wind, and Fire. You know? Oh, man. My favorite writer is Stevie Wonder. Yes. Yeah, if you're in love with somebody when you get home, Google as AS and play it for the one you love. As around the sun, the earth knows she's revolving. And the rosebuds know to bloom in early May. Just as hate knows love's the cure, you can bet your mind is sure that I'll be loving you always. That's fucking Steve. He put his foot in that motherfucker. My woman ain't got no oldies like that. You know, when she's 90, she gonna be talking about, shake that ass! Watch it. I love Mystical, but that's not a good song for the elderly. You don't want grandma at Thanksgiving walking around with macaroni and cheese talking about, I come here with a dick in my hand. Well, grandma, put the mac and cheese down, grandma.